Excuse me.
What's up, Aztec fans, and welcome to a very special National Sign Day edition of the Extra Point with ASR. I'm Agustin Gonzalez, joined as always by Edward Lewis. And Edward, as National Sign Day wrapped up, the Aztecs had 19 recruits, 24 if you count on the transfers. If you could pick three gems from this class, who'd it be?
That's tough because there's a lot of these guys have to still grow and get into what they need to be, like a guy like Nico Siragusa, a guy like Ben Moa. But right now, if I had to pick, Quade Miller, the offensive lineman from Ramona, DeMonte Casey from Cajon High, and Kendrick Mathis from Buena High in L.A. Those three, to me, are guys that could find their way into the starting lineup next season. I'm not saying they will, but right now I think they have the physical skill set and the ability to be starters, maybe even next season as true freshmen. But I think those are kind of your gems, your cornerstones from this class.
And the Aztecs really targeted the offensive line to fill some needs, six offensive linemen coming in. And Edward, there were a couple of surprise signings today with Chase Favreau and Terry Poole.
Yeah, Terry, we talked to Coach Tony White and Coach Rocky Long, and Terry was a guy they had extended an offer to recently. He was on his visit January 20th, I believe, that weekend, and they had extended an offer to him about a week ago, and he was down between Fresno State, San Jose State, and SDSU, and they honestly didn't even know where he was going to sign 5 minutes before he signed. So when they got that LOI in, it was perfect for them. So that's kind of why we didn't hear about a commitment, because he didn't commit until 5 minutes before he signed. With Favreau, it's a guy, I think they were looking at a guy, him walking on, and they didn't want to lose him. If they told him, let's walk you on, come in, they didn't want to risk another team offering him. So they said, here, let's just give you the offer. You're a great player, and we'll see what we can do with you at quarterback or even safety. And so that's how the story of those two guys happened.
And Edward, it wouldn't be National Signing Day without a school like SDSU losing on a couple of recruits. Who are the two biggest recruits that SDSU lost out on?
Really, I mean, the only two recruits that they lost out on today, obviously last week they lost on Darren Barrett and Travis Coons, who decommitted, but today they lost Devion Shelton, the four-star corner from LA. He had supposedly Washington and SDSU in his top two, and he's going to pick between one of those two
as
today.
Of last night, according to Rocky Long.
As of last night, yeah. So USC came in and offered way late, like 4 o'clock on Tuesday, and then he, of course, that's his dream school, so he picked them. And then Nolan Beagle, the linebacker, SDSU offered him on Sunday. He got it down between Penn and SDSU. You and chose Penn today. But when you go through signing day and those are your only two losses, I mean, you came out pretty good.
And Edward, Coach Rocky Long's philosophy is to recruit athletes. He talked about it today when recruiting Seamus McMorrow, who he said was more of an athlete than and more than just a kicker. And also, there's players like Matt Morin, Chase Favreau, Alex Barrett that they recruited as really supreme athletes that could play different positions.
Yeah, no, and that's kind of the big thing that's the theme of the class. I mean, like you said, he said Seamus was even an athlete. I mean, their kicker was a safety in high school. So they're going with that whole athlete theme, that kind of TCU strategy where we're going to pick the best player off the best team and see how he fits in our squad. There was talk from the coaches maybe that Alex Barrett could be an offensive lineman, but that doesn't look like it's going to happen. Rocky said he's a little too small, and it probably won't happen. Favreau could easily be a safety. Matt Morin's played linebacker in high school. DeMonte Casey's played running back, wide receiver, corner. Back safety, he could switch to any one of those positions. So I mean, there's a lot of guys here. Dan Common could even switch to outside linebacker. There's a lot of guys in this class that have a lot of versatility, and that's why they're probably Aztecs today.
And Rocky Long even said today that if he even were to change Matt Moore and Chase Favreau's positions, it wouldn't be until next year after they compete and they have a chance to redshirt and be the scout team QBs for next year.
Right.
And there you have it. For Edward Lewis, I'm Augustin Gonzalez. For more National Signing Day coverage, keep it tuned to AztecSportsReport.com.